Hello! In this video, we'll be taking a deep dive into parsing key value pairs from PDF files, which is crucial for working with forms distributed in PDF format. Before we jump into the hands-on demonstration in the Google Cloud Console, let's quickly review what we'll be covering. We're going to be using a service called Document AI, which is designed and managed by Google. It's part of the Google Cloud platform and is a pay-per-use service, but don't worry, it's quite inexpensive unless you're doing very high-volume PDF extraction work. The concept is simple. We have our PDF files on one side, which will feed into Document AI. On the other side, we'll get our parsed data in the form of key value pairs. We won't need any extra services or advanced coding work, as we'll be using Python to interact with the Document AI system. For our adventure today, we're going to use the Vertex AI Workbench service in a new Google Cloud project. This will give us an affordable Jupyter-based Python environment for experimentation. We'll largely stick to the defaults when setting up our notebook instance, as we're just trying to get started and don't need to spend a lot of time on configuration. Running this notebook for the demonstration should only cost about 20 cents per hour, and we'll only need it for around an hour at most. Once our instance is up and running, we'll head over to the Document AI section of the Google Cloud Console to set up a processor. Processors are the way we do this PDF parsing in the Document AI service, and we can either create custom processors or use off-the-shelf ones. In either case, we'll need to enable the API first. Next, we'll set up a form parser, which is particularly useful for extracting key value pairs and other structured data from forms in a way that other parsers may not. We'll give our parser a name, select a region, and then we'll have a serverless PDF parsing service ready to use in both Python code and the GUI. To get a sense of what this service can do, we'll upload a test document with synthetic data provided by Google Cloud in their documentation. After a quick upload and processing, we'll see that the service has captured key value pairs like dates, names, and other fields. It's not always 100% perfect, but it's much more useful for most software engineering workflows than simple OCR, or optical character recognition. Now that we've seen what the Document AI service can do through the GUI, let's amp things up and use Python to perform this kind of analysis. We'll open a Python notebook in our Vertex AI Workbench environment and bring in that same example form. Keep in mind that this service works the same way for both PDFs and images. In our Python notebook, we'll start by importing the necessary libraries. We'll need the Google Cloud Document AI library, of course, but let's also import pandas so we can perform some data analysis on the parsed results. If the Document AI library isn't already installed, we can easily take care of that with a pip install. With our imports sorted out, let's get some basic variables at the top of our notebook, such as the project ID, in this case, key value PDFs, the location of our processor, and the processor ID. We can grab the processor ID from the Document AI interface. It's an automatically generated value. We'll also specify the file name of our example form using a PDF version to demonstrate PDF processing capabilities. Next, we'll bring in some code to set up our Document AI workflow. This will involve specifying the location of our API endpoint and setting up a client using the Document AI library. We're using a region-based API endpoint to keep all calls within the US. We'll use the constants defined earlier to get a reference to our processor, read our example PDF into memory, and then send it over to the Document AI service for processing. Let's run this code and see what we get back. The result will contain the parsed data from our PDF. To make this data easier to work with, we'll extract the document from the result and use it to generate our key value pairs. We'll loop through the form fields returned by the parser, extract the field names and values, and collect the confidence scores provided by the service. We'll append the names and values to separate lists, which we'll then combine into a pandas data frame for easy analysis and visualization. We'll print out this data frame to see what we've got. The result is quite similar to what we saw in the Document AI GUI. We've got field names and their corresponding values, along with confidence scores indicating the parser's certainty about each extraction. With this structured data in hand, we're well on our way to being able to use these key value pairs in our software engineering workflows. Keep in mind that there's also a batch API available if you need to process a large number of documents, for example, from cloud storage, and you don't want to read them all into memory. As usual, you'll find the Jupyter Notebook code and the diagram from this video in the description below. We hope this walkthrough has been helpful. Please leave any questions and comments, and we'll do our best to address them. Thank you for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.